have a question for you. I have this basketball hoop geometry, and I would like to do a simulation for the following scenario. So a lot of times when a basketball player runs up to dunk the ball, they grab the hoop on the way down. Can we do that kind of simulation in 3DEXPERIENCE?
Yeah, absolutely. So I see that he's actually dunking and he's holding it for quite a bit. And then there's a lot of, you can see that the hoop is actually, you know, bouncing because of that. Yeah, we can simulate an effect where you know, we can apply a pressure to the end of the hoop and we can simulate such that he's actually hanging onto it to some extent. So this is the...
Mostly I'm interested in just the displacement of the tip of the hoop and what's going on in the where the hoop is connected to the
sure.
Backboard.
Yes, so that is absolutely 100% possible. So I can see that, you know, in this geometry we have four holes right here. I'm assuming they are for, you know, bolts when you have to bolt them together on each side. But from a simulation standpoint, let's start from something very simple.
Mm-hmm.
So what I propose right now is we can, just to see if the tip displaces, you know, as expected, let's first create a simulation of the basic tie connection between the two parts. So I see that these things are two different parts. So this one is the backboard, and this one is, this entire component is a rim. So what we can do is, instead of actually connecting them using bolts, we could simplify the simulation for the time being. Let's create a tie connection between the two components.
Mm-hmm.
And then we can run a simulation by just applying a tip load or like a pressure load to a very small section of the hoop. And then we can figure out what the displacement is. Now, after that, we can take it to a, we can add complexity by basically introducing virtual bolts. Since we don't have actual bolt geometry,
right.
We can introduce virtual bolts. The advantage of virtual bolts is that it actually reduces the number of degrees of freedom because you don't have to mesh physical bolts when you have them in your assembly. And it's going to be driven by one connector element is what it is. So it's going to be reduced to that amount of simplicity. But it's also increasing complexity of the model because it is going to mimic a real situation where you would actually bolt you know, the two components together. Now, by introducing bolts, now the other thing is also, you know, the other thing that you need to introduce is contact between the two components, because if you just bolt them together, these two components will not recognize each other and there might be penetration when you apply some amount of bolt force. So you might want to introduce some contact so that the two components are aware of, you know, their presence. And by doing that, this will increase the complexity of the simulation. It will take a little longer to run, but the results should be very comparable.
Okay.